All right, what's good, ladies and gentlemen? We are here at the Ripple Effect. It is episode 3. We're about to have a crazy, crazy fucking episode. Short episode this week. We got an hour-long episode. Big shout-outs to everybody in the chat room. I can see everybody there. Shout-out to SK Slick. Shout-out somebody going under the name MC Curse. I'm pretty sure that's not Curse. So come on, man. Use your real name. But shout-outs to everybody out there, man. We're about to have a live experience. We're going to interact with you. And we have a guest this week who is here with us right now. Introduce yourself, man. Who do we have?
Yo, it's Harjot Singh. Yeah, fuck yeah, it's me.
Harjot Singh, fuck yeah, it's me. And if that is on your gravestone the day you die, bro, I'll be happy as Larry. All right, man, so look, I want to get straight into this. This is a little segment I like to call Let's Start the Show, and this is where I start to introduce the guests. So what I want to ask you is, how did you first break into the music scene, man?
Yeah, well, to be honest, man, I didn't know anything about the music scene in Australia, you know, especially the Aussie hip-hop scene, but I was just doing my own thing, you know, fucking just making tracks, recording on my table, just filming me. I don't know, if you've been following me, you would have seen those, but that was about 3 years ago. And then,
how old were you?
I was, started when I was like 16.
16, all right,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, late 16, so yeah.
So you started to spit schemes at 16?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. All my music's on YouTube from when I started, you know what I mean? Just type in my name and shit and you'll find it.
That's cool, man. And I think maybe about 2 years ago is when you hit me up. And I get this, like, I get this video clip in my Hotmail. I check it out and it's you on some deep shit, man. Yeah, I forget. Bro. Did you remember what the name of the track was?
Yeah, that was called Suicide, you know?
Suicide, man. That was some deep shit. And I was like, this kid has got a lot of heart. Still didn't know how you would go on the battle tip, but I was like, this guy's a good writer. He's deep. He's got a lot of heart. Little did I know, bro, like roughly 6 months later to a year, a lot of motherfuckers knew your name. Your music was starting to get out there. You had a battle. I'm going to ask, how did you break into the battle scene, man?
Oh, the battle scene, all right. Well, you know, I was just a fan of the battle scene. I remember Station... I didn't know anyone from Station Battle League, you know? Shout out to Devastator, TGD, all them.
Big shout outs, Devastator
but,
and TGD,
you know, I was always interested in the battles, but got beef is Adelaide, you know?
Yeah.
Sydney didn't really have a battle scene until Devastator put on Station. Then I saw people, you know, going to Station events. I saw the videos and I thought, you know, I'll go check one out. Not to battle, just, you know, to check what it's like. I went there. And, you know, this is some exclusive shit as well.
Exclusive.
I met Uber One. Like, you know, he's a rapper from Hustle Hard.
Don't know what
he's doing now, but, you know, he had a name back then, you know? No one knew me.
So,
on the way to this event, this Station battle event, I actually met him on the way. And I was like, fuck, I've seen you on Hustle Hard and shit. Then he started tagging along with me, right?
So this is where you're having you're going to a rap battle
Station? Yeah, that's right.
Versus Uber One.
No, I wasn't battling.
Oh, you didn't plan a battle?
Bro, we didn't plan to battle, but it happened. When we got there, he was looking for an opponent, right?
All right.
And he was like just going around, you know, fucking, or you battle me.
Battle
me,
cards?
No one wanted to like battle him and shit. So I was like, fuck, I'll just step up, you know? And when I stepped up, he was shocked. Because he's like, this is the cunt I was just walking to the event with. He didn't even know I was rapping, you know?
He didn't know I was a rapper.
So when I stepped up, bro.
The brave Harjot stepped up.
Yeah, I stepped up.
Polished his turban.
So I stepped up. We battled. It was promo. But, you know.
It was a good battle, man. I think to be honest, like Uber in that battle probably wasn't at his strongest, but I feel like you came off really well. And it was mostly on a freestyle tip, yeah?
It was. Yeah, that's right. It was a freestyle battle. It was just like, you know, it came out of nowhere, so...
That's fucking, crazy, man.
Yeah, that's not crazy. On YouTube because, you know... Yeah, I'm going to say, he didn't want it to go on YouTube straight up, but...
When you put yourself out there and you like, put on a battle, yourself out there, it should really be publicized, in my opinion.
You know, the footage is still there. Devastator's got it, so, I mean, you know, we might put it up. We'll see what happens.
Yeah, man, let's, like, even if we have to hold Uber One at knife point and get this battle online, we'll do it, man. We'll do it.
Yeah.
We'll do it. We'll see who the real cunt is then. All right, so I want to ask you something. Hustle Hard, man, is like a big movement out in Sydney. I know originally where Hustle Hard probably rose to fame is Curse was dropping music videos on there.
Yeah, that's true.
And I guess you are, so you're down with Gunster, who runs the whole Hustle Hard thing out there. How did you get into the Hustle Hard thing, man?
Actually, yeah, so you know how I said I started rapping on my table, yeah?
Yeah.
Then that's when, you know, I was like, fuck, what am I, like, just, I don't know anyone in the scene. Let's see if there's a scene, you know? So, I don't know, I remember my brother showed me a battle of Cursor. I think it was like Melodramatic versus Cursor or some shit.
Oh, that's a got beef battle. Classic. You know it's legit.
Yeah, my brother actually knew the Aussie scene before me, my little brother. So he actually introduced me into it kinda, you know, he just used to watch and shit, watch the battles. I watched Cursor versus Melo. Then I realized, fuck, there's actually a scene here. And then I started looking up Cursor and shit, and I realized he was getting like views on Hustle Hard TV, you know what I mean?
Yeah, so I went on YouTube.
I was like, you know, let me hit up this fucking channel. I hit up Gunstar, and I messaged him. I was like, you know, how do I get on Hustle Hard? I was like, you know, is it cool for me to work with you? And he actually already had seen the videos of me on my table and shit.
That's crazy, man. So he'd seen some of your shit too. So your shit was reaching people.
It was, which was surprising. It was already reaching people. And then, then from there, you know, we went from there. I just met up with him, and then, you know, I did my first track. That was Suicide.
Not the
one I linked you for the Got Beef, remember, in your email. That was Suicide on my table. But we redid it on Hustle Hard. That was my first song.
All right, man, that's crazy. So once the whole Hustle Hard started to go down, that's where you really started to, I guess, get the fans really break into the music scene.
More.
Then you started doing a few rap battles. Let's cut to last night. You had a rap battle against Massa. Big shout out to him. Yeah, also living in Sydney. How did the battle go down last night, man? What are you feeling?
No, I feel good, man. It went down good, bro. Like,
that is cool.
You know, I wasn't even nervous, man, which was good. Like, usually I get heaps nervous and shit before battles, but I went in there confident, and I think I did my thing, and yeah.
Man, we had a good crowd there last night, man. I think the crowd was really receiving you, and you were energetic last night, man. You were hungry.
Yeah, definitely. The crowd was really good. That played a part in my hunger, bro. Like, you know, just made it more entertaining. I mean, made it more, you know, like, fucking, the atmosphere was so good, you know?
Yeah, for sure, bro.
It was good.
All right, man, so the way we're going to do this, we got a little shit talker in the chat room too, man. His name's Chippies. Yeah. Fuck you, man. Yeah. All right, anyway, we're going to keep going with the show because we keep it cool, man. This is the Ripple Effect, episode 3. Shout out to everybody in the chat room right now. Big shout outs to Fat Drake tuning in. We're going to interact with you over the show, man. We want to bring you into the show and make you a part of the show. So, what we're going to do is we're about to get into our next segment, bro. Racial comments in the chat rooms and shit. Tough motherfuckers. All right, man, we got a show to do. Let's keep going on with it. About to get into a segment I like to call Let's Get Live. This is where you motherfuckers that are tuning into the show are going to be able to see Harjot Singh spitting live performance. Is going to be video streamed. So, ladies and gentlemen out there, if you've got friends that you think want to see this shit, start linking them right now. So we're going to get live. Harjot, what do you need, bro? All right, Harjot is dispensing the chewing gum that's in his mouth. But, bro, we're about to get a real, real fucking set cranking by Harjot. And look, man, it's a pleasure to have him out here. And I also want to say to everybody tuning into the show, man, give us some feedback. Let us know how we're doing. And obviously, the show's a little different this week, but we're still going to keep it nice and fresh for you, man. How are you feeling, Harjot? You ready to jump in?
I'm ready.
This is a segment I call Let's Get Live. What's the first track that you're doing today?
Need some sleep.
All right, so we're going to do a track by Harjot, and I'm kind of feeling him on this one. Need some sleep. I fucking need some right now. But I'd rather see you perform live. So we're going to get Need Some Sleep by Harjot. We got three tracks from Harjot today. I'm going to let you take it, man. DJ Sweet. Blitz, bring him in.
Do I need headphones or anything?
Bro, you're good. You just spit. You do it raw, man.
Cool. Yeah, ready.
All right, this is Need to Sleep by Harjot.
This was for my first mixtape as well. Message to the Ignorant is the name of that one. But let's do this.
Need some sleep. You can't go on like this. I tried counting
fuck
sheep,
up, Packy.
Spit
me. Get off the chat room, you cunt.
Need some sleep. You can't go
watching that. The ripple effect.
Alright. Now I'm sleeping, I'm dreaming, you won't believe me. I always dream of being on TV and selling my CDs. There's only one way that I can make all this happen. I gotta put my head down on the mic and keep on rapping. I really wanna practice cause I know I got the passion. People say I got the talent, I ain't waiting for no magic. I'm just a boy that couldn't even do fractions. And now I'm thinking whatever, man, I'll forget mathematics cause I don't need it, man. Yeah, you never believed it. Now you know the reason why I didn't listen to teachers. I dream of doing shows, tour around, good crowd. I had a dream, I headlined a show with a full house. Then I woke up and I was thinking, shit, why did I have to wake up, man? I didn't wish for this. Why did the lightning awake me? Or maybe I might be crazy because I'm writing shit daily. I'm thinking, why am I waiting?
Need some sleep. You can't go on like
shout out to guest 496.
Sika.
Ch-
Shout out to everybody in the chat room, man. And big up Hajo, killing it right now. This is exclusive.
This next verse, bro. Yeah, this next verse is one of my deepest ones, so listen. There's people that always judge me on my appearance, and that's alright, but I know it, cause I can hear it. And I've been hearing all these type of things for years, and after all this time I still don't care, it's something I can deal with. But that's me, there's other people out there, due to their looks, they don't even leave their house, yeah. It ain't fair, man, discrimination, I still don't understand the reason why people give people hatred. It doesn't matter about the race and the colour and the elder age and younger and the scale that shows the number, whether overweight or under, if you're gay, straight or another, male or female, either way, I'll be your mate, I'll be your brother. If you're thinking you're different, you didn't listen. This is written with some rhythm, now I'm spitting my vision. I'm here to help, if you need it, then I will give it. I help you with my dream, and that's music, so I'ma live it. Need some
sleep. Killing it hard, John. Like that's a deep shit too, man.
Shout out to Koza MC. We're in this all together and I wanna help you. I wanna put an end through your worries and clear your head too. I wanna help you with none of that stupid Satan shit. I wanna give you all something so you relate to it. You can listen but also you do not have to. But either way this is a song that I'ma rap through. I've got respect for every single one of you. No matter what you look like, I'm not here for judging you. Cause I'ma stay real, I'm not a phony. If you know me, then you'll know I'm not a phony like Kony. All you people that know me will know my music is growing. I'm getting closer and closer to where I know that I'm going. And now I'm telling you, all you people supporting me, you're the reason that I do this, and the reason I'm normally writing songs every second. There is no time to rest, and I wonder what's coming next. But I want you all in my presence.
Yeah. I'm feeling that, bro.
Yeah, that's that one.
Need some sleep, educating these motherfuckers, man. If you're feeling hard, y'all, let us know in the chat room, man.
Shout out to Mellow Owner. Fucking sitcom, bro.
Bro, it seems like you got some good, like, response here, man. The crowd is loving that, man.
Fuck yeah.
Big shout out to Koza, man. It was good meeting you on the weekend as well, man. Alright, man, so we're about to get into your next track.
One?
What do you got next up for him?
The next one's called Always Be The Same.
Always Be The Same.
Yeah, yeah, this one was also from my first mixtape, you know? These are one of my favourite songs, so this one.
Alright, man, so get ready for Hard Job once again. Keep fucking with him, and you know what, bro? You're killing it right now, man.
Jeez, bro,
these fans
it.
Are yours. Let us know how you're feeling about it. This is exclusive. This is Let's Get Live. Hard Job, you're up, bro. Take it.
Sweet. Alright, this one's called Always Be The Same, so listen. Now I got a mic, now I'm gonna rip it up, spit it up. Every single week I'm dropping different stuff. All you people help me so much, why wouldn't I give a fuck? Thank you all so much, and now it's time for me to give you love. Yeah, look man, I'm telling you that I'm different now. I'm just kidding, but I'm gonna pick a different route. I'm just joking, man, why the hell would I ever change? Only thing I change is my outfit when I am dressing, mate. Apart from that, man, I swear to God, I am really pumped. If I ever change, I want all of my fans to beat me up. And if you don't, then I promise you I will beat myself. I wanna stay the same and never change, I wanna be myself. So that is what I'll be, I'll never be a clone of you. Hardrot sings a name and I'ma do what I'm supposed to do. And that is rapping, I'm doing it for the youth. I do it for the people, yeah, man, I do it for all of you. If you're feeling down, my music is what you should listen to. This is true, so pick and choose, there is no need for different tunes. Assist you through your problems, your business and all your issues too. With you and I'll be here, my lyrics are made for fixing you. Yo, it's hard to sing, this is who I'll always be the same, never changing with my poetry. Always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, so that all you people know it's me. Yo, it's hard to sing, this is who I'll always be the same, never changing with my poetry. Always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, so that all you people know it's me. I don't like to be cocky, that's why I never am. But I know for a fact that I am better than a lot of people that rap about drugs in all their songs. Okay, you do cones and bongs, there is no need to show it off. Rappers run around screaming, fuck you, what, bruh? Bro, I can be your doctor. I'm not saying that just because I want the fame. I want you all to listen to my music, I can make a change. I don't like to say it loud, but I have saved lives. I have saved once, I have saved twice. I have saved thrice, no, I have saved five. Wait, hold on a second, man, yo, I have saved nine. The reason that I'm telling you is so you people know I'm here. I am here for you, I'm telling you that I won't disappear. I'm telling you right now, straight from my heart, I will never leave, and I'm here to make my mark. Yo, it's hard to sing, this is who I'll always be the same, never changing with my poetry. Always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, so that all you people know it's me. Yo, it's hard to sing, this is who I'll always be the same, never changing with my poetry. Always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, yeah, I'll always be the same, so that all you people know it's me.
Ah, Hajo, killing that flow, bro. That's on point, bro.
Sick, bro.
You got a new mixtape out now, yeah?
Fucking knows. Yeah, this next track I'm gonna do is off the mixtape. So
alright, so this is off the Losing Myself mixtape?
This one is actually for my first ever mixtape.
Okay, your first mixtape.
That's called Message to the Ignorant. You can find that on Google. Just Google it, you know what I mean?
Alright, man. And make sure you hit up Harjot Singh's fan page on Facebook too. Type in Harjot Singh and follow this man, because he's doing big things, man. So sorry, what is the name of this next joint again?
This next one's called Green Bag. This is off my Losing Myself mixtape, my latest
Green
one.
Bag, I've heard this one, man. We actually played that on our Sunday Spotlight on the first show. This is Green Bag, I co-signed this. Man, I'm gonna let you spit it, bro. Take
Sweet,
it away.
Bro, appreciate it. Let's do it. Real shit. Green Bag. Yo, let me tell you what I do every day now. I go around to the playground and I don't know why, but I stay out till the late hours of the night. I don't go home and I just lay down in the dark on a bench on the grass, and if I'm lucky then at my mate's house. But I don't know why I do this shit, but I have to. I didn't want to tell the fans, but damn it, man, I got bad news. I'm a good kid, I've done good stuff, but I've done bad too. I'm ashamed to say it, but read the title. Yeah, it's a sad truth, it's normal at this age, but I was falling into place when it comes to rapping. I had a chance, now I'm throwing this away. I'm losing myself. People know what's up, my bros are drunk, I'm so crunk, now my flow it sucks, but oh my god, this is so much fun. Fuck, I'm telling no lies. Never in life will I know what heaven is like if I keep this up, but it ain't me, it's a devil inside. Fuck, God needs to help me. Why? Cause I'm not feeling healthy. Green bag, green, 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 green bag. Green bag. It's a motherfucking green bag. Yo, when I used to come back from work, I'd be writing songs. I'd take you on a journey with me and you would ride along. What's going on now? I'm lighting J's and I'm lighting bongs. I'm trying to stop this shit, man. I try behaving, I'm fighting strong. It's got a hold of me now. Yo, it's slowing me down. It's hard to quit, but listen up, cause I'm showing you how we can affect you. We can keep you depressed too, but don't listen to me, cause I am about to leave for a sesh soon. I got kids that look up to me. This shit, it fucks with me. I want the old days back when I was living so comfortably. Lots of kids are annoyed with me cause I'm a stoner. Hot box with the boys, sitting in my Toyota. God's given me a choice to go drinking or to be sober, but I'm stopping for a joint as I'm sipping on this Corona. Fuck, God needs to help me. Why? Cause I'm not feeling healthy. Green bag, green, 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 green bag. Green bag. It's a motherfucking green bag. Yo, listen to this next verse. Hi, my name is Marijuana, nickname is Mary Jane. Let's play and have some fun, nah, this ain't a scary place. Hardrock, don't be mad at me, I am a real nice bitch. I ain't provoke this tragedy or make you feel like this. I just want you to feel good and forget about all your issues. I would hug you if I could, never let you down when I'm with you. But this is your fault, hey, you left me alone. The dealers got me trapped in this bag, they ain't letting me grow. You need me, Hardrock, buy me, I'm very cheap. Believe me, Hardrock, you can finally get some sleep. Come see me, Hardrock, you can grind me like every week. Don't leave me, Hardrock, come on, find me and set me free. You can put me in a blunt, pack me up, rip a cone. You will be in love, I'm that happiness in your throat. Fuck me, Hardrock, give me another chance. Believe me when I say I'm different to other plants. I'm trying to help you.
Green bag, green,
green, fuck yeah.
Green, green, green bag,
green bag, baby.
It's a motherfucking green bag.
It's a motherfucking green bag. It's a motherfucking green bag.
Alright, man, we just had Harjot Singh getting live. That was all three tracks.
Yeah, bro, fuck you. Yeah.
Man, now you do have a new mixtape out. It's called Losing Myself. Yeah. Where can they get it, man?
You can get it from hotnewhiphop.com. To be honest, just go on my Facebook fan page. That's facebook.com/HarjotSingh Music.
Go to the fan page. Harjot Singh on Facebook. Go to the fan page because you'll be able to find everything. We also had somebody say that we should bring you in ADL to do some shows, man. Some people are feeling you.
Fuck yeah.
What do you think, man?
I'm so keen to come back here, bro.
We're going to make it happen, man. The first time that we had Harjot out here was when you were shooting the kids' music video, yeah?
Yeah, that's coming out soon, maybe in a week or something.
That's coming out soon, man, and I was there for that. It's really tight, man. And that's the first time we had you out here, and we made sure as soon as you got out here that we brought you back.
Yeah.
And here we are now in the studio, man. So we're about to get in our next segment that I like to call Let's Talk Rap. And this is where we talk rap in the media or whatever we want to talk about.
Sweet.
First, I want to ask, we're talking about rap. Do you have any independent or mainstream artists that you're like kind of listening to in rotation right now?
At the moment, man, it's got to be Hobson, man. I've been listening to Hobson for so long, I still do.
Have you heard that Ill Mind of Hobson?
Yeah, I heard that last night, man.
Is it good, bro? Because I still haven't heard Number 7.
Oh, it's amazing, man. Me and Godfrey were checking it out last night. Check out Ill Mind of Hobson 7 if you guys are fucking listening.
That's tight, man. That's tight. Yeah, that's one of my missions when I get home.
You guys are talking about Pornhub and shit, bro.
Bro, we shout out everybody in the chat room, but we don't get consumed by the chat room during the show. I will say shout outs to everybody that's been cool in the chat room. And we really appreciate everybody tuning in. All right, boys, let's bring our heads in. Yeah, We're not clowning around. Now, in rap at the moment, is there any projects that you think people should be looking out for? Any independent artists that you want to be shouting out?
Independent artists?
From anywhere, anybody on the underground scene that you think people should be checking out?
Fuck. Who's killing it? There's a lot of people killing it, man. I mean, I listen to quite a bit of UK rap as well.
Who do you listen to?
You know Mike Righteous, yeah?
Mike Righteous?
Mike Righteous, yeah, fuck.
I've heard some of his shit, man. I've heard some of his shit.
No, I'm not like a big fan, but like the shit I've heard, bro, that guy needs to be heard more.
Definitely, man. There's some tight rappers out in the UK, bro. Definitely. We played a track from a rapper called Young Gun last week. Have you heard of Young Gun before?
Oh, nah.
Super tight, man. He's been on the scene for years. Yeah? That guy kills it out in the UK. Another dude I recommend is Kalashnikov, man, from the UK.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of him. Yeah.
That's on some real tight shit, man. All right, so what we're going to do, we're going to get into our next segment. Now, this is where we play some music. This is called Listen Up, where we got some tunes. I'm going to get DJ Blitz. Let's get this set up. I'm going to let DJ Blitz move over here and grab some of the tunes. Can we get you over here? And big shout-outs to everybody, by the way. We've had somebody else say that they listen to Mike Righteous too, man. So yeah. I think there's some fans in there.
Hell yeah.
Now, Blitz, all the tracks are just in there. USB is at the back. All right, so ladies and gentlemen, you're getting everything really live right now. Please give us some feedback and, you know, let us know how you're feeling about the show. Real pleasure to have you here, Harjot, man. And we're definitely going to get you here for more battles, more shows, man. Let's fist bump that shit.
Keen.
Right, so while we're here, you know what I'm going to do? While we get set up for the tunes and start playing this music, why don't we get into our next segment? Just hold on 1 second.
Cool.
All right, it's in the download folder. It's got all four of the songs there. All right, apologies, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get on with the show. So I think we should get into a segment I like to call Gabbin' Bout Games. This is where we're going to talk about some video games.
Yeah.
You down for this? You ready?
Yes, I'm down.
All right, man, let's start talking about it. What video games are you playing right now, man?
Okay, right now, bro, definitely GTA 5.
GTA 5, you know I'm on that, man. GTA 9.
I know you are, bro. I dominate that shit, bro.
Big shout-outs, Beef Team. Shout-outs to Ploppelcopters in the chat room. He's in my Beef Team crew on GTA Online.
Fuck, I ain't fucking around then.
Man, we are worldwide, bro. So GTA, like, you just play GTA 5 or you play the online too?
Oh, well, I finished the story mode like 3 times, bro, with all 3 different characters.
That's cool,
but,
man.
Oh, yeah. Like, I did the last scene with each one, you know? I just wanted to see how it ends.
So you wanted to play it a different way?
Yeah, ends differently, you know what I mean?
That's dedication,
bro. But after that shit, bro, online is the thing, man.
Online is growing, bro, because you, like, a pack just came out last week. It was called, like, the Independence Day pack or something like that. New missions came out, and you, like, death matches and fucking survivals and
Man,
it's fucking crazy. The thing I like about GTA Online, and I've said this on episodes before, for some reason GTA gets brought up by our guests every single fucking week.
Well, I think
it's because everybody's on top of that shit.
That good of a game.
But
man,
it's growing, man. It's a thing where the game doesn't stop. Whereas before, when we used to play video games, you play it, you get your play out of it, and it's done.
Yeah.
But this is one of them games that just keeps updating, man, and I love the fact that it's crazy, man. Now you play GTA Online?
Yeah, I do.
What rank are you right now?
Bro, I'm like 55.
I have to be honest, bro. I've got two characters. One's level 173, and the other one's level 170.
Bro, you got a lot of times on your hand, man.
Bro, you know what's really bad? You know when you go to your stats on GTA 5 and it shows how many days I've spent online playing GTA Online?
How much is
I
that?
I think it's at like 42 days.
Oh,
or something
shit.
Like that. It's a lot of my life, man.
Fuck.
That basically means 25% of 2013 for me was spent playing GTA Online. So it's worth it, man. It's really been worth
RuneScape.
It, bro. I think putting the rap career on hold and just putting the whole rap battle fucking scene on hold so that I can play GTA is a real unselfish thing for me to do.
Definitely.
So, all right, anything else that you're playing right
definitely,
now, man?
Definitely, bro. FIFA all day, every day. FIFA's
other people say FIFA too, man. Now, what FIFA are you playing right now?
Bro, right now, FIFA 14, I got the latest one.
So you're playing
one.
FIFA 14. FIFA 14. Now, I've only got FIFA 13. Mm. How was FIFA 14 different to the previous FIFA?
Bro, they're all the same. They
but
only
it's
make
just
like
the graphics
one.
Graphics are getting a little better.
A little
or
bit, yeah.
And obviously, they update
you know,
the teams and
they
shit.
They change the defending shit, like tactical defense. Oh, that was from like 2012, actually. I don't know, man. But they keep making shit a bit better. But yeah, now FIFA 14, I love it, bro.
For me, like, I played FIFA 2011, and then I didn't get another FIFA until 2013. I could see a big difference between those two.
Yeah.
But I think when you're getting FIFA every single year, it's like slight difference that you notice.
Definitely. Well, if anyone plays FIFA on PS3 online, write your username in the chat, and I'll add you, and we'll
do
play.
Do that, man. And if anybody out there is on Xbox 360, I am Decoy the MC. That's the gamer tag. Decoy space the space MC.
Yeah.
Make sure you get on it. Somebody in the chat room, Mello Wanna, just said, I play Mario Kart.
Bro, I love Mario Kart.
That motherfucker's old school, man. I respect that shit.
Yeah, dude.
That's
fuck
cool, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm not even hating on you, bro. I just downloaded all them Sonic games recently.
Yeah?
I've been
fuck
playing
yeah.
that shit, bro.
Sick on, bro.
Me and my boy were playing like as Sonic and Tails.
Yeah.
And we forgot that like two-player games back then aren't as good as they are now. Like back then, like your friend will disappear off the screen while you're playing
yeah,
two-player.
That's true.
And you need to try and catch up to him so you can both play together probably.
Yeah, man. Definitely.
All right, man. That was gabbing about games. I don't think we should chat about games too much now because we need to get on with the show. Mm. Harjot, pleasure to have you in here as always. You know what? You know what somebody just said in the chat? They're calling us nerds because we play video games, brother. Are you going to stand for that shit? Because I'm personally offended, bro.
I'm fucking... Bro, if a nerd is what I am, I'm fucking happy.
Bro, if I'm a nerd, I'm happy too. But what I will tell you is when we're on tour, man, when we're doing shows... You know what we do when we get home?
Yeah.
We take our Nikes off our feet, we sit down on our bed, we smoke a little weed, then we start playing some GTA,
that's
man.
It,
that's how
that's
I do.
It. So I don't
if
know
that's
what the
a nerd, bro, I'm happy to be a nerd.
Yeah, that's
it. And the guy that just called us a nerd also said, I play Halo. Kill yourself, man. Kill yourself. All right, we are about to get into a segment that I call Listen Up. And this is where we pick some tunes that we think are fresh, that we think people need to hear. Mm. So we're going to get into this segment, and then we'll bring Hard Job back.
Cool, I think
before we close out the show, are you down to do a cypher at the end of the show?
Yes.
Just spit some verses or freestyle or something?
Yeah, definitely.
We've also got the kid here in the studio. He's not in here right now, but he's around here somewhere. But he'll be here to be in the cypher as well. Big shout-outs to everybody in the chat room. I have to say, man, now today we interact with people in the chat room every week.
Yeah.
Today I've seen more haters in the chat room than ever. But you want to know what I always say, man?
Yeah.
Haters only hate up. They don't hate down.
Oh, definitely.
Haters only hate on people above them. So look, thank you, bro. Well, we want to thank everybody out there that's sending out the hate too, because we're here to school you, man. We're here to school you. And for anybody saying, I mean, Harjot, you know, he's from India. We've got some people saying, Harjot, why don't you go and bomb shit? Why don't you go and blow stuff up? Give us your address and Harjot will bomb shit.
I'll give us
the address of where you live and Harjot will bomb shit. And I'll show you how a white boy goes crazy too, because I'm going to help him. I'm going to help him detonate that shit. Anyway, man, this is a segment called Listen Up. We're about to get into the first track. This is from Bizarre of D12. Do you fuck with D12, man?
Oh, yeah. I mean, back in the day, yeah, for sure.
Back in the day, because they haven't, sure. I mean, even released an album for 8 years or some shit. But this is actually by Bizarre of D12.
Okay, cool.
This is a solo project he had, and this is called Fat Boy with King Geordie. And this is basically Bizarre just talking about the life of being fat.
Yeah,
and being under Eminem and just being that fat boy.
So he's happy.
D12.
He's happy with him.
He's a happy man, and that's he's got King Geordie. King Geordie on this shit, man, and this is a good track. So this is Fat Boy by Bizarre. We'll be back with Hard Jot. Listen up.
DJ, spin that shit. Deep.
You weighed a whopping 321 pounds. Bizarre, please step on the scale. Tonight, your weight is 333 pounds. So what do you have to say for yourself, Bizarre? You gained 12 pounds.
You suck! I'm a tail marshal.
So what do you have to say for yourself, Bizarre?
I just been watching TV and eating Hot Pockets.
'Cause he's a fat boy, but he's moving like Beyonce. Fat boy, and he's dancing the night away. Fat boy, but he's moving like Beyonce. Fat boy, and he's dancing the night away.
Alright, man, we are back. We are about to get into the next song. This is a segment that I like to call Listen Up. So we're about to get straight into the next song. This is actually from an album that was put out by Grindtime Now, the Battle League. It was called Fresh Coast, Non-Perishables Volume 1. This is by Lush One, XI, Only One, Immaculate, Chase Moore, and Awkwards. It's called So There. And I feel like you guys are really gonna enjoy this shit, man. So can we please get everybody to give us feedback on this next song? This is So There by the West Coast All-Stars, man. DJ Blitz, drop that shit.
Sorry if I'm out of line, I'm drunk too. Matter of fact, scratch that, I ain't sorry for nothing. And tell them if they got a problem, then fuck, I don't give a fuck. I ain't so drunk at the bar, I'm throwing chairs and dump the skunk in the cigar that smokes in the air. And I don't give a fuck who you are, I don't care. And you know your girl's in love with a star, so there, bitch.
Is Rilla, Rilla, Rilla is I really, I really split ill, fill it with light. Fire up that LA confidential. But I'm blowing out like a brass menstrual. Check the scales, selling bags of reefer. The fashionistas, the wine mixers, and Catalina. I'm a triple stack, Tom and Katie and Brangelina. Blasting heat at the Federalis like I'm a Zapatista. Rebel, bet I blow more than a bundle. Swinging through, hitting more trees than George of the Jungle. Speed lugging in your squeeze, I'm exploring a tunnel deeper in the cave. Digging for gold, it's sort of a hustle.
These motherfuckers trip up verses that I type up. I don't drop 16 bars, I spit nightclubs. My dick in your girl's left hand with the right stuff. I ain't got a cup, so I cheers them with a pipe. I got the purple burning, blood got me perking. Thick enough to fucking hurt a virgin.
I'm tight, you pussy.
Merc and serve on my swing a magic stick, you bitch. Smoking on that candy jack, banging my lung dumb. Why you got that old look like you facing a gun holster? The mix on chickens get it, then the colonel gets pounds. While a simpleton but little Kim, I turn a bitch stand.
So you ain't tryna drink with us, then fuck you. Sorry if I'm out of line, I'm drunk too. Matter of fact, scratch that, I ain't sorry for nothing. And tell them if they got a problem, then fuck, I don't give a fuck.
I ain't so drunk at the bar, I'm throwing chairs and dump the skunk in the cigar that smokes in the air. And I don't give a fuck who you are, I don't care. And you know your girl's in love with a star, so there, bitch.
We can't come to terms and power struggle in the underworld. In the belly of the beast, among the stomach worms, I got gas and cash stuffed inside the furniture. 12's in a whip and it's uninsured. What's the word? These prices for me is sky high. I treat the booth like the front seat of a drive-by. People don't dodge bullets, they see it in sci-fi. My everyday life is like reading a high time. Introduce a chick to me, she better be fit to breed. In school we had history, now we have a history. I love women that know how to work a triple beam. I love women from Italy and the Middle East.
I'm fresh in my fitted hat. Test where my limits at and overstep.
Only question.
Guess where the chickens at? Fed them the chicken scratch. Less of the chitty chat. More snake jaw before blessing the kitty cat. Yeah, stretch it out. I'm the best when I'm hitting that. From behind, arms around the neck like a piggyback. Give me that. While I count cash. Thick chicks giving fish lips like a wide mouth bass. Shit, I'm in this motherfucking place so deep. Got game when I don't speak. Paying for your drink. Bitch, you tripping. I stay with my clothes. Crease the face of a young boss, brain of a OG.
So you ain't tryna drink with us, then fuck you. Sorry if I'm out of line, I'm drunk too. Matter of fact, scratch that, I ain't sorry for nothing. And tell them if they got a problem, then fuck, I don't give a fuck.
I ain't so drunk at the bar, I'm throwing chairs and dump the skunk in the cigar that smokes in the air. And I don't give a fuck who you are, I don't care. And you know your girl's in love with a star, so there,
so
bitch.
Watch me do my thing and rock like pure coke. Step up in this bitch in a kangaroo fur coat. Boomerang in your boot, lodging her throat. Having mood swings from that Rossi or Merlot. Fuck the piece that you took, or the heat, or the snub. Bang this beat in the club and get beat with a club. Everything I say slurry with that lean in my cup. And your bitch pay me monthly, she leasing my nuts. And that's a pink slip when she's eager to fuck. Even take the kitchen sink that her lease is up. You know there's cash in the streets if you need to re-up. Be a master of the peas, and I don't mean
See, I do this for the kiddies, getting pennies from the strip that had to hear people tell them that the city wasn't shit. Now I'm on my grizzly getting busy running this. I'm a tad tipsy drinking Jack whiskey from the fifth. Now my biggest life decision, where we finding the bitches. And am I wearing the fives or the sixes? A typhoon, we can write you songs, pal. Battle you or fight you, cause my crew's hostile. The best in the west since Ice Cube dropped down. I mean not bad for some high school dropouts. This is our year, we gon' rep it today. And I dare you to get in the way. Motherfucker, let's go.
You ain't tryna drink with us, then fuck you. Sorry if I'm out of line, I'm drunk too. Matter of fact, scratch that, I ain't sorry for nothing. And tell them if they got a problem, then fuck, I don't give a fuck.
I ain't so drunk at the bar, I'm throwing chairs and dump the skunk in the cigar that smokes in the air. And I don't give a
give a fuck who you are, I don't care. And you know your girl's in love with a star, so there, bitch.
Alright, ladies and gents, now a few people have asked me the name of that track. That was from the Fresh Coast Non-Perishables Volume 1 album. That was Lush One, XI, Only One, Illmaculate, Chase Moore, and Awkward's So There. And that was produced by Chase Moore. If you want to find that track, just type in Lush One, So There in YouTube and you'll be able to find the YouTube video, and then from there you'll probably be able to get the links. Now, we're about to go into our next song, man. This is a really fucking tight radio show. We've been getting really good response. Blitz, I think we are the best hip-hop show going from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. on a Sunday. What do you think, man?
Without a doubt.
Without a doubt. All right, man. Let's get into this next song. What do you think?
I reckon.
This is by Prime. This is one of Adelaide's best MCs, man. And this is called Restore My Faith. DJ Blitz, drop that shit.
Things that I gotta let them slide if I
There's a big gap between the new and the old me. If I can't control things, then I gotta let them slide. If I can, then I gotta get them right. I woke up early to assure my place and saw the house full of signs when they saw my face. But if I should die before I wake, then let the next night restore my faith. Restore my faith.
All right, what's good, ladies and gents? We just had Restore My Faith by Prime. If you go onto YouTube, man, type in Prime, Restore My Faith, you'll see the music video. That's the title track. What do you think of Prime, Blitz? What do you think of him?
I don't know. Prime's pretty good on the scene at the moment.
You into that shit? He hasn't done anything since that Good Morning project that dropped on Soulmate Records, but I think that dude needs to make more music, man.
Does.
Bringing DJ Blitz into the show. You know how it is. We're trying to involve him more, man, but he's so shy. And we need to bring him out of his shell. Now, we're about to get into the next track. This is the final track of our Listen Up segment. This is actually by a good friend of mine, man. This is by Madness, all the way over there in Florida, currently residing in LA. This is Madness, Classy. And the track speaks for itself, man, because he's a classy, fat, jolly, happy man. This is Classy by Madness. Drop it, Blitz.
Classy, 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 I'm so
Alright, we are back. This is Decoy. We just had Classy by Madness, all the way in Florida, currently residing in LA. That was a dope track, man. And again, go to the YouTube, type Classy by Madness, and peep out the music video, man, because that's some crazy shit. Now, I'm bringing Harjod back. Harjod, how you feeling, bro?
Yeah, I'm good, man.
Man, it's been a pleasure to have you out here from the weekend, man. It's been a pleasure to have you on the show. And man, you've just been blazing, haven't you?
No, you've just been blazing.
You've been smoking that weed, and it's not good enough, man.
True.
You know, smoke weed, man. I love weed. I can't even get mad at it. All right, so what we're going to do is we're about to get into a segment called Politic, and I'm going to start 5 minutes on the clock. Are you ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, man, we're starting the 5 minutes right now. So the recent controversy about the Malaysian Airlines flight, there's been a second flight that has just been gunned down, we believe by the Ukraine, we believe it flew over, I guess, war-affected waters or whatever. How are you feeling about that shit? Giggles?
Nah, bro, that's fucked.
Hard drop McGiggles thing?
Straight up, that's fucked, but, like, whoever does it, oh, it's not me, by the way, I didn't hijack that plane.
Some people were suspicious, man. If we're going to be real about it, it is really messed up. And it seems funny to me. I saw something on, like, I Googled the situation today. And I saw something about a lot of the bodies that have been recovered from the debris are still kind of intact. And a lot of people are saying if a passenger jet had been bombed, the bodies would be obliterated. So people are suspicious of why are they finding bodies still intact.
True.
They're suspicious if the airline was even gunned down.
Can I stop you there for a sec?
Yeah, go ahead.
Are we talking about the recent one? The one that got shot down?
The one that just got shot down. Yeah, Apparently, they found a lot of bodies
intact. They found bodies.
And they think if a plane actually got gunned down, that they should have been obliterated.
Oh, right.
Because when that shit is plummeting, it's going at a speed that's ridiculous. Bodies should just splatter into jelly.
So they're curious of what it was.
So, man, either it's not even what it looks like, or there's just something about that whole thing that we don't understand, man. But what I want to understand is why somebody would go out of their way to gun down a passenger jet carrying 200-plus passengers. Like, that as motivation alone doesn't make sense to me.
That is so...
There must have either been something on the plane or somebody on that plane that they were targeting. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's right.
It's some shit we can't understand, man. I mean, look at that Malaysian airline flight that just disappeared. How does that happen, man? With all the technology we have today, how the fuck does that shit happen?
I'm still confused, man. Fuck.
So to me, man, I don't know what's going on. I think the world's in a really funny place right now because I think a lot of countries are on edge and... You know, we could see a war breaking out, man. Like, we don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah, the world's fucked today. Seriously.
It's fucked up.
It is, man.
If anybody out there has some opinions, man, start talking to us, man, because we got a few minutes left on this segment. What do you think it is, though, man? Because they're trying to say that the Ukraine is going through wartime right now. There's a bit of unsettlement between Russia and the Ukraine. They're trying to say they think it might have been war-related or something like that. What do you think, man?
No, it probably was war-related, bro. I mean, to be honest, I haven't been following it too much. But from what I've seen, now the shit's fucked at the moment, eh?
See, what they're trying to say, too,
Palestine
is like...
Palestine and shit.
All the shit that's going on in Palestine.
Yeah.
Let's touch on that really quick.
So the
Jews are kind of invading Palestine right now, am I correct?
I'm pretty sure, yeah. If you tell a Jew that, they won't say that, but...
No, but they're trying to claim on a religious ground that they can claim the Palestine back. But really, when the Jews originally had Palestine, they invaded Palestine anyway. So they never owned the country. I heard a Jewish guy say in an interview that... the UK gave them the Palestine. So he's trying to say the UK gave us Palestine back when the UK was ruling. And it's like, man, how can somebody else give you a country? That doesn't make sense.
That's true.
I think it's disgusting, man. And if you look back to the Holocaust, where we saw so many people dying.
6 million.
You know, we're kind of going through that again. Like, if you go on Facebook, man, I've actually seen photos of some of these tortured bodies.
Yeah, dude, fuck, that shit's...
Because you can't hide
it
anymore.
That's been all over Facebook these days.
You can't hide it anymore, man. We live in an age where everything gets shoved in your face.
That's true.
I saw a 5-minute clip that was actually going through the hospital beds and showing the conditions
Bro,
some people were
I see
in.
That shit down the newsfeed. I try not to look and shit.
But it's already too late. I'm trying to look at some of that shit.
Nah, it's fucking... Some of it's, like, actually disgusting, bro.
It's horrific, man. And what we need to realize, we're human beings.
We're lucky to live here, bro.
We really are, man. And I'm sure, like I'm nothing against the Jewish people out there, too. I'm sure a lot of them don't agree with it as well. I just think it's...
My best friend's Jewish, so...
Yeah, you know, and I know some Jewish folks as well, and probably they don't approve of it, man. But the fact is, this is a human thing. This isn't a Palestinian thing or a Jewish thing. This is a human thing, and we certainly don't want that happening in Australia, but we still should be just as passionate about when it's happening in other countries, man. And these are human lives. It's fucked up.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
We are currently living in a world where planes get shot down out of the air.
Yeah, man.
Countries are invading each other on really weak grounds that date back to shit that doesn't even really matter. It's just stupidity, man. So, yeah, man, we're living in some terrible times right now. We could talk about it forever.
Yeah, we
but
could.
But I think the bottom line is that it's just not cool, man. It's not cool.
Yeah, nah, it isn't. It isn't. Fuck it.
Somebody's just tuned in to say, did you hear on the Malaysian airline that there was a dude that was an AIDS researcher on the plane? Yeah, apparently there was a lot of people on the plane.
Yeah,
there was like 24 Australians,
like,
right?
Yeah, I heard like 4 passports were fake and shit as well.
Yeah, four people
on
there.
They
were suspicious
passports.
There were some Malaysian spies on the plane.
Oh, Malaysian
like
spies. Oh, right.
But apparently one of the guys was a really strong AIDS researcher that was going to a conference.
Yeah,
somebody we've lost now, man. I mean, he could have been on the brink of finding the cure and he's lost now.
True, bro.
So that's fucked up. I have to put a curb on this segment, man. That was politic and we had 5 minutes. If anybody's got any feedback, man, hit us up on Twitter at Ripple Radio and also find the Ripple Effect on Facebook, man, and get in touch with us. You can contact me on Twitter too at Call Me Decoy. All right, so what we're going to do, man, we're going to end the show. DJ Blitz, you got some instrumentals for us, man? This is how we're going to end the show. Can I have the kid and Godfrey up here as well? All right, go ahead. All right, so what we're going to do, this is what we call Let's Get Live, right at the end, man. We're going to take this out. We're going to sign off the show. We're going to have a cypher. I've got the kid in the building. I've got Godfrey in the building. I'm going to let him introduce themselves in a second.
Yeah.
DJ Blitz, when you are ready, my friend, we are just going to get straight into this shit. We are ready. All right, so what I'm going to do, I think I'll rap first, then we'll get Harjot in. You guys just alternate that mic, all right? Off the top, I'm sick. Always got the chronic lit. My mind does not exist. Yo, I'm ill on that Godfrey tip. And I'm about to get Harjot to bum you, bitch. Harjot sing. The bars he brings are so damn dope. I will smack a cat's throat with my rap quotes. That's the way we do it. I'm the guy that spits that amazing music straight from the top of the brain. Often insane, the chronic I blaze is like Dr. Dre back in N.W.A. It's the shit that you really don't understand. And you know you're the kind of guy that'll get body slammed. This is Decoy, I'm the hottest fam. Sounding so good whenever I'm on a jam. Controlling the beat, exploding with heat. All you atrocious MCs ain't known to compete. I'm too damn ill. I'll fucking crush your body with an anvil. And I can drill your body to 1,000 pieces. I gotta say you suck like a mound of leeches. I'm profound like Jesus when he gave speeches to the religious. Decoy spitting with that unusual sickness. Got your girlfriend doing my dishes. You know I'm the kind of guy that moves so swift. It's me, known to spark pot. Now I'm about to pass the mic over to Harjot,
Damn, you took so fucking long, I'm getting fucking tired. I swear to God, I see you, I would get a fucking wire. And right tight around your neck, I know I'm fucking up now. But I come around, I swear to God, I got the underground sound. Cause I'm never going mainstream, this is shit I'm doing for life. I come around and yeah, motherfucker spewing tonight. Cause I've been drinking a lot, coming around, drinking the grog. I don't give a shit cause I'm shooting right now, that motherfucker, yeah, I'm spitting it hot. Shit, yo, I kinda fucked that up. But I come around cause yeah, I love the drugs that I'm fucking smoking, yeah. Decoy's like, woo, yeah, I gotta kinda take a poo.
Oh shit, yo, yeah. You hear Decoy scream, woo, just like Ric Flair. Nobody can blaze the koi, make some noise. I'm like Ric Flair, shit, yeah, I'm that nature boy.
I'm that nature boy, but you guarantee I'm flowing strong. And I'm smoking my weed and feeling open bomb. Now I'm not, this is the joint, bro, but you get the point, so I can keep on going that annoying flow. You pass the microphone, I need to kinda talk louder or walk prouder. If I do it, well, I will devour. Woo! We got a guy that's waiting to go on. I'm creating the flow strong, I'm waiting for faux bongs. Shit.
Spitting to the beat now. Come on, you know I got the heat, pal. Check it out, my brain does not exist. I'm gone persistent, I'm gonna let Godfrey spit. I keep that chronic lid, like I always say. Now Godfrey spit when you walk down the hallways, man.
I'm walking down the hallways, man. Godfrey on the mic, through the hall of fame. Is where I'll stand for the rest of my life. Yeah. No one's testing the mic. Godfrey, I'm resting at high, living the life. To the skies, flying away. What you gonna do? Mess with me, you die today. So yo, I'll leave you inside the grave. And it's Godfrey, I'm not beside a slave. I don't know, but I will kick that flow and read back on it. Godfrey on the mic and I
don't go smack.
Just in case you ain't tuned into this net, you should click on the net and listen to the Ripple Effect. We don't disrespect cats, this is the Ripple Effect. I already said that, signing off. Big shout outs to Harjot Singh. Say goodbye to him, man, say goodbye to him.
Yeah, shout outs to everyone that tuned in. Except the actually, no, it's all good. Even the haters. But,
like I said, man, haters only hate above, never below, man. Never below.
Yeah, no. Shout out to everyone. Fucking sick cunts.
Big shout outs to Harjot Singh and Hustle out, Hard, yeah. Man. Who else did we have on the show?
I was just in the background doing my thing. You
come
know
and
what
say goodbye to him, man.
Come
sign
and
off.
Say goodbye, that's the way I spray tonight. Cause when I say goodbye, you know that I'd be crazy tight. Hajjad on the left of me and Blitz to the right. We be ripping at night and I'd be kicking inside. So B-boys, decor, yo, it's time to sign it off. I could rhyme a cough, doesn't matter, I'm still pulling the finest stuff. So pass it back to the boy who's just presented it. And I'm just coming with that demented shit, replenish it.
Replenish shit. And then I smoke hella spliffs, I'm the reason that we all exist today. Spit on stage, I'm a comedian like Rick Gervais. When I get in your face, I'm not the one you wanna intimidate. I'm spitting flames anyway. Who else do we have? Who else do we have? Get on the mic right there, who else do we have?
Let's get that big hanging in there.
Godfrey, we're signing off right now. You're gonna say goodbye to him. You're gonna say goodbye to him.
Goodbye to the people.
Goodbye to the people.
I gotta
people.
Say something. Know this, you're low. You're not high, we're not equal. Thank you for the love on SoundPond. All right, now I'm going to go home and down pot, smoke that shit until I'm sound rocked and I'm buzzing off my head and run to the shops to go buy some bread or some milk.
Hey, we all need our milk and our bread, bro. That was Godfrey Agala,
I just
man.
Said how I feel.
Big shout outs to everybody, man, and even shout outs to the fucking people that are hating on us, man. Like,
yeah,
we appreciate
yeah. Shout
that
out to
shit
them
too,
the most,
man.
Actually.
But actually, man, I gotta say, most of the people have been really cool, man. They've been really cool. We're getting good response to the show. That was episode 3. This is the Ripple Effect. We are out of here.
Peace.